Father, we thank you this morning. We give you all the glory and we give you all the honor. We bless you for bringing us to your presence this morning. We thank you for each and everyone's life. We thank you for all our listeners, those in the YouTube, those in the Facebook. Father, we thank you for your visitation, Lord. We thank you for your protection, and we thank you for their well-being in the name of Jesus. This morning, your word is about to come. Speak through me, God. Let your people be blessed through your word, God. Let your word change and transform them, God, and lift them to a new level of your blessings in the name of Jesus. We come against every attack of the devil, every network of the devil, we cancel it in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, visit your people. Open a new chapter for them. Let them see your glory. Use me as a vessel of honor to glorify your name. We thank you, Father, for answering prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, shout a big amen.
Amen.
You can sit down
with me at
as a queen and a king.
With Ohene and Ohema.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you for coming.
Me sure I will sell by.
Today God gave me a word, and this word is for somebody specifically. I have entitled my message, "What did you see? What do you see? Ask your neighbor, what do you see?" Amen. Open your Bible to Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 10 up to 12. Jeremiah chapter number 1,
Jeremiah itibako,
verse 10 up to 12. I read the King James Version.
King James.
See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant. Verse number 11. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Jeremiah, what seest thou? And I said, I see a rod of an amo tree. Then said the Lord unto me, thou hast well seen, for I will hasten my word to fall. Verse number 12 again. Then said the Lord unto me, thou hast well seen, for I will hasten my word to perform. Amen.
Amen.
What did you see? Amen.
Amen.
The passage that we read is about a young man who was a prophet of God, and his name is called Jeremiah.
The friend Jeremiah.
Jeremiah was a prophet.
Jeremiah, you know, Oyedifor.
When he was the clot of blood in the mother's womb.
Now, Oye, Mojato,
that God knew him. So God ordained him as a prophet when he was in the womb of the mother. So when he was growing up as a young man, one day God appeared to him. He said,
Jeremiah,
I have put my word in your mouth, and because of my word I have given you the power, the audacity to destroy, to pull down, to build and to throw out. Amen. So this is the power I have invested in you.
I
have ordained you
that
anything of the devil you have to destroy. Any kingdom of darkness, you have to uproot it. Then build a new thing from. And apart from that,
Jeremiah,
I want to test you.
I
have said all kinds of things concerning life. But let me ask you one thing. What did you see? Amen.
Amen.
There's a difference between Luke, L-O-O-K.
Luke, and I said share.
And the word C-S-E-E. When you say look, we are talking about the physical thing. I look at this camera. So look, it's presenting what your physical eyes can locate. But in this scripture, God asked
Jeremiah,
what did you see? That see stands for vision. Vision is the power of your imagination. That is called vision. Vision is what your physical eye cannot see. But you can see it through your mind eye. For instance, everybody have a house that he or she lives. Right now, I want you to picture your house. Though you are in the house of God, far away from your house, but you can use your mind to locate your room
while
you are staying here. So
while
you are seeing where you are staying, that is called vision. That's called power of your imagination. So God asked
Jeremiah,
what do you see? And Jeremiah answered God, I see an amotly. Amen.
Amen.
And God said, you have seen a good thing. Then I am watching my word to perform. Amen.
Amen.
This means anything that you see, anything that you imagine, anything that you visionalize, that is what God brings you to pass. Amen.
Amen.
He said, what do you see? He said, I see an amotly. It means he was looking at the vision. He's looking at the power of his imagination. And Jeremiah saw an amotly. And God said, you have seen the amotly. And it is a good thing. Because the benefit of the amotly, you had no idea. But Jeremiah, I want to announce to you, I am a God of a positive God. And every good and perfect thing is for me. So if you have seen a good thing,
and it's a woman, the papa dear,
then I am watching my word to perform. This morning I am here to ask you, what do you see?
They
are people, they always see death. But anything that you see, it is what God will bring you to pass. Amen.
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 What do you see? Then you said, I see myself having a wedding.
And in the word of God, Bible says it's not good for a man to be alone. It means marriage is very important to God. So the moment you see it from afar, though physically you have not seen anything, and that is what God will bring that vision to pass. Amen.
Amen.
You see, anytime you want to see the thing physically before it comes to pass, it will never come. Because nothing happens unless it has been manifested in the spiritual before physical. What do you see? There's a power in imagination. Our mind is like a magnet. Anything that your mind will imagine, it is what it will come to pass. Bible said, as a man thinketh, so he is. So if you are a child of God and you want something from God and you want the physical manifestation, you first see it afar. See it from your vision. And because it's the word of God, he said, I am watching my word to perform. I pray for you. I see you having Babylonia. I see you like a Babylonia. From this man going, you will count billions of dollars. I see it for you. And God said, silver and gold belongs to me. So if you see money, then I am watching my word to perform. May that be your portion. May that be your portion. Anything that you see is what God bring it to pass. Amen.
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 Never look at anything. When you read Second Corinthians chapter 4 verse 3 said, if the gospel be hid, it is hid for those who don't believe. Because the God of this world has blinded the mind of those who don't believe. So the blessings of in the Christ people don't see. We are in the time that devil is bringing unbelief to people. They thought your situation will be like this. So devil has been manipulated and polluted people's minds that they don't believe what Jesus can do. And it is better for your physical eye to blind than for your mind eye to blind. Because Bible said, where there is no vision, the people perish. People were perishing because they don't have vision. And the vision is the power of your imagination. The Christians were expecting good things from God, but it is not coming because their imagination are all evil. Always they were thinking negative, but the moment you see a good thing, God said, I am watching my word to perform. It's not that God is not answering our prayer, but he was answering what we see. That's why be careful about what you imagine. If you imagine money, man will come. If you imagine positive thing, it will come to pass. If you imagine good marriage, it shall come to pass. If you imagine fruit of hope, it shall come to pass. Don't look at the physical aspects. He said, Jeremiah, what do you see? Anything that you see, anything that you visionalize. It is what God will bring back
to you.
I see this church going the whole world. And a time will come, you will see me every Sunday on the television. Worldwide. You not see me on the physical aspect again. That's what I see myself. And I see you. But a year by this time, you have your twins. I see you that you are healed. I see you having your own business. And God said you are seeing a good thing. Because a hand that does not work does not eat. So if I've seen a business, then I am watching my word to perform. May God bring all your vision to pass. Never think negative. From today, change your thinking. Let your thinking faculty bring you positive results. What do you see? What see about your children? I see my children become the president and the ministers. Don't see your children as unrobbers. See them as a prominent people. And whatever you imagine for your children, that's what you can see. If you see your children as a useless people, that's what it will manifest. What do you see about your children? What do you see about your life? Oh, today the situation seems bad. But what do you see? Don't wait for the physical manifestation before you confess positive. Believe that God can do anything. Because Bible said, and we know that all things, and that all things is three categories: good, bad, and ugly. Except for those who love God.
So
when you love God, sometimes you experience ugly. Sometimes you experience bad. Sometimes you experience good. But God sent all these things into good. So no matter the situation you see yourself, don't confess negative. Because God used three things to create a soul. He used mind. He used the intelligence. And he used the ego.
And it said the whole feeling.
Open.
Amen.
So these three things that God used to create soul, your mind, your intelligence, and your ego. So that thinking or vision we are talking, we are talking about the soul realm. And nothing happened unless it has seen in the soul realm before physically. And in the soul realm, everything is possible. That's why you are in Ghana here, sleeping on your bed. You had a dream that you are in America. And second, you came back. After you wake up, you see yourself that you are in your bed. Because your soul has traveled far away and come back. So in the soul realm, everything is possible. The same thing happens. The soul is your mind. So anything that you think, it is possible. Anything that you imagine, it is possible. You say, what do you see? See from your mind eye that you will never die premature. See yourself. You will not be poor. And that vision will come to pass. If you don't imagine good, You will experience negative things. Bible said, I wish above that all may prosper and be in health as your soul prospers. That soul prospers is talking about your mind. What you imagine? What do you see? Ask your neighbor, what do you see? Tell him, I see myself as a boss. I see myself as Mrs. and Mr. Say, I see myself as a twin mother. I see myself as a car owner. I see myself a landlord. I see myself building an estate. And God said, you have seen a good thing. I am watching my word to perform. Have a good vision. Use your mind to have a vision. Sometimes you don't need a prophet to prophesy. Just use your brain. Just use your mind. Visualize something. Write it down. Just walk on by faith.
Though
the vision will tally. But at
that
appointed time, because in his own time, God makes everything beautiful. Maybe you have having that imagination. You have not seen a resource. The vision is yet for an appointed time. And today is your appointed time. That every vision will come to pass. I will not that premature. You will not that premature. Sickness is not your portion. See yourself that you are moving forward. Backward never. But forward ever. When you are walking, stop putting fear in you. Though you can sit in a car, because of you, no accident. Tell yourself, I'm going to get married. See your wedding. See your wedding day. How your husband is giving you the ring. And as you imagine that, as you visualize that, then God said, I am watching my word perform. What do you see? We are about to pray. God is asking you. Yes, you can break. You can destroy. But if you don't have the power of imagination, it is difficult for it to come to pass. What do you see? Though the past months have gone, you have not seen anything. That was a liar. He manipulated your mind and you don't believe. So how can it be? I don't know anybody. In my family we are poor. How can I build a mansion? If God say yes, no one can say no. If God say he will bless you, he don't look at your family background, neither your education background. What he want to do is what he will do. That make him God. I profess to you, before you leave yet your house, I see your expectation coming to pass. I see your prayer request be granted to you. I see God granted your prayer request in the name of
Jesus.
None of your family will die premature. Poverty is not your portion. I see you moving forward. I see a breakthrough coming on your way. I see financial breakthrough coming on your way. I see healing power. I see your fruit of womb coming. Receive your children. Receive the favor. I see you working with the president and the ministers. I see overflowing blessing. I see overflowing healing. Receive that grace. Receive that favor. As you are imagining, it will manifest physically. Because God said, I am watching my word to perform. A time will come. And he's the child. You see grace of life everywhere. We are going to build 40,000 capacity.
40,000
underground.
Underground.
Glass temple.
glass,
with air conditioning, wherever you are, this mission is what we are going to do. A time will come, and this is the time. Before you enter here, this place will be underground.
When
after your wedding, then you come and serve here. Then you come to the top. This is our vision. It shall come to pass. Bible says vision is an appointed time, and this is our time. God has studied your money. Is working behind the scene that people don't know. So a time will come, and this is the time, that grace of life will move forward. God will bring the loyal people, the white people, they will come and serve us. You will see white people within the ground, and it will shock you. They'll be the protocols, they'll be our singers, they'll be our ushers. This is our time, this is our vision. We don't see what we are seeing now, we see afar. But what do you see? I see an outwardly. He said, I am watching my word to perform. Have a vision for yourself. God created everybody for a purpose. No matter your condition, no matter your family background, see yourself as a superior. Don't let people limit you. Limitation is a disease.
Hello.
I said the limitation is a disease. Exert yourself. Sometimes speak big. Anytime that you speak big in the positive manner, people thought you are arrogant. People thought you are proud. It is better for you to be proud by speaking in positive than to become humble and speak negative. Your destiny is in the hand of God. Today I bless you. I see God blessing. I see God favor. I see God prosperity manifested physical upon your life. You make it in the name of Jesus. Sometimes you don't need many people to be a blessing to you. Just one person can change your destiny. Receive that one person. Receive that one person. I see that one person coming into your life to change your situation. Receive your healing power. Receive that favor. Anything you have expected for years, I see that vision coming to pass. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I see God prepare a table in the presence of your enemies. As I see God preparing a table in the presence of your enemies, those enemies who said nothing could come from you, I see God prepare a table. That table is big. The size of your enemies determine the size of your table. I see you having a big table. God give you a big table. It means you have big enemies. That enemies, don't kill them. After God prepare a table in the presence of your enemies, then they die. Your enemies will see. Those who are thinking evil, God will let it come to them. But today, if you have a vision, have it positive. Because he said, I am watching my word to perform. No one can bring you down. As father today, no money does not mean you are poor. Poverty is a demonic. Don't tell people you don't have money. When he asks you, tell him it's in pounds. I've changed it into dollars.
My sister, dollars.
Don't tell person I don't have money.
Can't you say,
I have. But I've just opened my dollars account. Don't confess negative. Bible said, let the weak say I am strong. And let the poor say I am rich. If you don't take time, devil will suppress you
to
speak negative and they start on it
to
manifest it physically. Tell the people you are a billionaire. I am not poor. I changed my mind into dollars. And I don't want to change because I am traveling. I'm going to a business trip. So if I see the, give it to me. When I come back from my trip, I'll send the dollars and give it to you. Speak positive. When you speak positive, your enemies will be confused. Your enemies will be confused. A time will come, and shortly you enter here with everything tightly here, without air conditioning. If you want to drink water, you just press your chair, and the water enters your mouth. It will shock everybody. Before you enter here, before you enter the stairs, the main entrance, we are going to do a machine. It will walk you and bring you here. No one will walk to this
end.
The machine will bring you.
Elevator.
Just you need to just enter. When you enter, it will bring you here straight. May that be your portion. I said we are confusing our enemies. I said the enemies will be confused because we have seen a good thing. And God said, I am watching my word to perform. I see every door open for you. I see you that we are dedicating your children. I see my children become a minister. My first boy become a president. And the second boy become the vice president. And my third boy become chief justice. And my fourth boy become the speaker of parliament. So wherever you go, if the president is there, my son is there, the vice is there. And that is my vision. And it shall come to pass. And it shall come to pass. And it shall come to pass. I see God lifting up your children.
While
people are crying, you will laugh. Don't look at the present and look at the future. There's something God has for you. What do you see? I don't know what you see. Do you want to die? Do you see poor? Do you see sickness? Then God said, I am watching my way before. We are about to play. See positive and it will come to pass. It's not a magic.
But
the mind is like a magnet. Anything that you visualize, it will attract. If you know the scripture, then God will give you a future. Because the preacher will give you the future. That's why you have to know the scripture. If you know the scripture, then you have the picture. If you have the picture, then you have a future. May God give you a scripture. Then you have a picture. Then God give a future. May God bless you. May He exalt you. May He go. And your heart desire will be accomplished. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Shout a big Amen.